Good day, everyone. This is Dr. Rezamisi Narciso, your subject teacher for the subject BAR 213, Good Governance and Social Responsibility. Okay, so right now I'm going to discuss to you some important key points for our class before the actual start of the class discussion. So we will have our class orientation with the following topics. We will discuss about the class schedule, the QIPAR utilization, our syllabus, and also a few reminders from everyone. So let us start with class schedule. And then, as you all know, no, there are two schedule present right now in our institution, the EMSA 1 schedule and then the EMSA 2 schedule. So our class falls into EMSA 1 schedule, which means that our face-to-face class will be held every Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. And then we will be having our asynchronous class utilizing the QIPAR LMS every Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. So there is a possibility, guys, that I will be giving you the quizzes and assignments on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. But there are also times na maghatagpod ko on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. Okay, so for the QIPAR utilization, always bear in your mind to regularly check your QIPAR every day na lang, para sure. But on the scheduling, Thursday, Friday, Saturday is really set aside for your assignments, quizzes, utilizing our QIPAR LMS. Okay, so in the QIPAR, as what I told you earlier, no, it will be on Thursday to Saturday, but it does not mean na when I sent quizzes and assignments is one day lang siya. So dili siya in ana. Okay, I will be giving you deadlines on a range of days. Dili lang siya kay one day, but then dili po siya long enough for you to answer it. That is why you really have to regularly check your QIPAR, kasi meron tayong mga deadline na ginaset every time na mag-send ko og mga activities. Okay, so all of the activities or the learning materials will be uploaded in QIPAR and will be sent via our QIPAR code. And I already sent to you the code in our GC, no? And I would like to inform everyone that biskan pang learning materials lang na, remember that we cannot send you anything without giving some questions, no? So biskan pag isa lang na siya ka question, basta magawa siya sa inyong QIPAR, you really have to answer it. Kasi tanan nga akong mga ginasend sa inyo, ha, biskan pag dili siya quiz, biskan pag learning material siya, biskan pag syllabus siya or mga other nga mga learning materials, I will be recording it. Okay? Biskan pag one question lang na siya. So dili ta magsigiog ka ng pangayo lang sa atong classmate kung unsay gisend ni ma'am. You really have to experience it. You really have to navigate QIPAR. You really have to download all the files nga ako ang gisend sa inyo, ha. Okay, so I just want it to be clear. Okay, basig pag-abot sa panahon puhon, matingala mo nga nung 0-0 ang inyuhang class participation, quizzes, and assignments. It's because wala nag-utilize sa QIPAR. Okay, so let's have our syllabus. Your syllabus for BAR 213, guys, is already sent, no, in the QIPAR. So kindly check na lang dito, then kindly download it for your references. So I will be discussing to you the content of the syllabus. So this is our syllabus, no, nga gamiton. So what is this syllabus, no? This will feature, or this is where we can see the course outline, what are the assessment tasks, and other na mga information para sa ato ang subject. So having a syllabus is very much vital para well-guided ang teacher and also our students as to what are the things that we should prepare. Okay, so this is the course name, Good Governance and Social Responsibility. And this is also the course description as to unsay makita nato diri sa subject. Okay, then we also have this program educational objectives, the PEO, that 3 to 5 years after graduation, it is expected that you can have all of these three, no? Then, alignment with our SO, as we all know, we have this what we call graduate attributes nga makuha jud ninyo supposed to be kung unsa ang mga graduates sa UMTC. UMTC graduates are having this galing, gawa, gawi, and gana. Okay, so this is also kaning A to T, these are the student outcomes and how does it relate to our graduate attributes and program educational objectives. Okay, so ang course outcome naman guys, upon completion of the course, HR management students of the BSBA program are expected to demonstrate the ability to identify and address ethical, social, legal problems in various business scenarios by applying appropriate governance principles. So, we will discuss things that will answer this one, no? So, hopefully, you will be able to demonstrate that ability at the end of our class. And then, second is exhibit analytical skills in identifying and resolving ethical, social, and legal issues. Kasi remember that this is good governance and corporate social responsibility. So expect that we will be discussing a lot about the about cases, unethical practices, for example, and mga legal issues nga ginabuhat sa mga companies. Okay, so yun yung mga course outcome, meaning at the end of our discussion for this term, hopefully you will be able to demonstrate and exhibit this one. So this is the visual representation, a presentation of our connectivity, no, gikan sa vision, mission, philosophy, our core values and competencies to the PEO nato, and then the course outcome and mga SO nato. So for the HR, we have student outcomes letter A to letter T. Okay, so ginahatag naman ako sa inyo ha ang katong syllabus. You kindly download na lang it and then you read this one. Now let's proceed to CO and assessment task alignment. So what will you expect regarding our assessment task? Meaning, what are the things that we will provide or give you as a tool to measure if you really get the discussion or not? No, so for first, second, and third examination, and as well as final examination, I will be giving you multiple choice questions. Okay, so for the first to third exam, 100% yan na multiple choice question. For the final exam naman, hati siya, meron tayong MCQ, then I will also give you a case study. So for the final exam guys, we have 70% of that is multiple choice ang scores ninyo. The 30% of that is for the case study. So rubrics natin, criteria, we have analysis and interpretation, conclusion and recommendation, writing style and clarity. So this is how I am going to give you points for your case study. So that is for your assessment task, no, for the subject per exam. Okay, so now let's proceed to the course outline and time frame, no? Based on what is in the syllabus. So, yung first week, di ba, hindi tayo nakapasok kasi ongoing pa yung enrollment natin. Pero, that time is allotted for the orientation on classroom and university policies as well as grading system. So, I believe that university policies are already discussed to you katong first year pa lang mo. Namoy mga series of orientation from the different offices, including the Office of the Students Affairs or the OSA. And I believe that you already have your student handbook. So, kindly review na lang that, no? Kay basta makalimot ta. And then, for our classroom orientation, mauna ni ako ang ginabuhat right now. And also, for the grading system, natay grading system nga gina-discuss sa inyo at all times. And at the end of this syllabus, naapod diri atong mga grading system nga ato ang mga dapat nga bantayan or i-consider. But I know that you already have an idea with that kasi naka-undergo na taog
first year level. So aware na mo kung unsa ang mga grades nga mogawas, no, and then mga criteria on computing your grades. Okay, we are done discussing about PEO, SO, and CO, and on the remaining topics is that we will have lessons, lesson 1 up to lesson lesson 13. Okay, so duha man gud ang ano nato guys, ang ato ang topics to be discussed, no. First is yung about sa good governance, and then second is yung about sa corporate social responsibility. That's why medyo mataas siya. So as for my class rules nato, I will be discussing to you the first lesson. Mag-discuss ko sa inyo ha, maghatag ko og kanang inputs regarding introduction to corporate governance na topic, in which we will tackle about what is governance, characteristics of governance, and basic principles of governance. Then the rest of the topic from lesson 2 to lesson 13 is that I will be giving it to you for your class reporting. So it's very vital nga dili lang sa ako amang gikan tanan, no, ang mga discussion. Kailangan jud og kanang participation pod gikan sa inyuhan. This is also a part for you to develop your communication skills also, no. Ang points ninyo ani day guys for the class reporting will be given in the research na part or the atong mga project, kasi at the end of our katong research and requirements pala. So at the end of our class, wala na mo i-submit sa ako ang mga requirements, yun na yung requirements ninyo. Kasi I believe you cannot give a good na performance for your class reporting if you will not conduct a research. Okay, so mo na siyang you will be divided into groups naman. I will just give you your groupings, but then you really have to prepare. No, you really have to prepare kasi natay mga rubrics nga mga dapat nato nga bantayan. And then you really have to give your best na during sa imong report, kasi once lang man ka nga mag-report ani nga class. Dili na man kaingon nga magbalik-balik. So, you have to prepare really. So, for the coverage for the first exam, natay tulo ka kuan topic, no? The lesson 1, yeah, lesson 2, lesson 3. Then coverage na po nato for the second exam, we have 4 topics, lesson 4, 5, 6, 7. Then coverage for the third exam, lesson 8 to 11. Then after third exam, napatay 2 ka remaining topics, but remember that on your final examination, guys, dili lang duha ka buhok ang coverage. Ang coverage nato is gikan lesson 1 to lesson 13. So comprehensive always ang final exam nato. That is why you really have to study. Kay gikan jud sa pinakasugod nato nga discussion hantod sa last nato nga discussion. Okay, duha ang libro nga atong gamiton, kasi as what I told you, duha ka subject ang atong itakal. The good governance and then the social responsibility. So, kindly refer na lang the book dito sa library. Available ni siya, Cabrera Cabrera, for the corporate governance. And then, for the CSR naman is kang Viernes. So, updated ang ato ang mga books, guys. So, kindly utilize po the books from our library, no? Kay daghantag mga newly acquired books po dito, ah. Okay, reference, assessment and feedback plan. Yun. For our quizzes, LMS activity, and homework, I will be sending that via LMS. Then, for our recitation, yun na, dun ma-fall ang yung mga, class reporting natin. Okay. Recitation and then yung sa research. So, in person na siya. Tapos, MCQ, of course, I will be giving to you that in person, as well as the comprehensive exam. And take note, no, base 15 yung grading system natin. Okay, I know that you're aware of that already. 4.0 is the highest na grade na mahatag sa inyo, ha. while 1.0 ang lowest na grade nga mahatag sa inyo ha. And remind lang po guys na 7.2 means that you have lack of requirements or lack of examination. 7.1 means that you have no final examination permit. So you have to comply. No need to give me the receipt. No need to give me the receipt of your final examination permit kasi in our CRMS always na siya nag automatic na siya update pag once na i-update sa inyong ha portal. Okay, take note lang, policies, guidelines, cheating, plagiarism, and all forms of academic dishonesty are expressly forbidden in this course and by the university's policy on academic integrity. So, example of such violations include but are not limited to collusion, purchasing, or commissioning on assessment task or research paper, copying verbatim from a research article, book, journal, or etc., copying verbatim from generative AI such as ChatGPT, and there are a lot of AI available right now, no? Kasi ang uban ng mga students sa Katapulan, dili na magbuhat og own or original na mga assignments. So, nag-ato na lang sila sa AI. Let the AI do that. I am not discouraging everyone to use AI kasi even ako nagagamit kog AI. But lahi rapod na siya ang story if ever nga tanan na lang content sa imuhang mag-submit is done by the AI. Okay, so we have a software that can detect AI right now. So you have to be careful with that, no? Most especially if nakay research. Okay, so falsifying or inventing any information, data, or citation, tapos false representation, yan. So base 15 grade policy should be observed, and students who obtain failing scores in major examinations are recommended to attend tutorial classes or any intervention programs. Okay, for other policies and guidelines, refer to your student handbook. Okay, so again, nasend na ko ang copy ani nga syllabus guys dito as a quipper. You have to download it para maanseran po ninyo ang questions nga naa dito as what I told you. Biskan pag learning materials na siya, you really have to download it by yourself para maanseran and then naa kay record dito as a quipper. Okay, so let's go back to our presentation. In the class reporting, as what I told you, no, natay class reporting, natay ginatawag nga rubrics, no, later discuss na ko tong rubrics. Rubrics is very important di ay guys kay that is when we can see nga kanang perfect ang ato ang score sa reporting. And that could also be your basis in the preparation nimo, no, para nindot ang imuhang reporting in your assigned schedule. And then for the class reporting, I encourage everyone to really do research. Ang libro nato nipis lang na kaayo. So much better nga mangita jud tag mga practical examples. Okay? Adto ta sa number 5, connection na siya. Ako mas mo appreciate ko mga practical examples when conducting a class reporting. Kay mas masabta nato ang ano ang topic or idea. Unsa man ang practical examples? Name a company, name some business practices. Yan. So kailangan nag-exist jud siya. Dili siya ingon nga based on your own opinion lang siya, no. Okay, then in your class reporting also, kindly present it in a bullet type manner. Okay? So dili nang puros mga words ang ato ang makita dito asa PowerPoint presentation, or worst, ang ginabuhat sa uban, what is in the book? Mura po'y ginabutang sa PowerPoint. Mura rag i-enlarge kung unsa ang nasa book. Remember guys that every one of us can read, no? What we really have to point out is to really understand what is written in the book. So muna siyang kailangan mag-conducta o research. Then, what do we mean by bullet type? Just like what I am doing right now, no? So, mga keywords lang, mga key terms lang, and you do the explanation. Now, question, ma'am, pwede ba ta magdala og notes? Okay, pwede na siya. But it's a different story if puros na lang ka magsalig sa imong notes. Magsige na lang kag basa in the entire class ni Mudiraa. So it can affect your performance during sa class reporting. So you really have to prepare, guys. Okay, then mas encourage nga presenta o pictures or logo as much as possible, no? Kay mas masabta na to mga visual learners, magunding mga students na to diri ano. So example, mental company, Apple company. So instead of typing Apple, then you download the logo of the Apple nga koan company. So para mas dali siya nga or masabtan, then magets dayon sa ato ang mga audience. And then also nakabay group man mo guys, kailangan nato mag conduct og teamwork kasi in our rubrics later on, most of our criterias there is actually promoting teamwork, no? Kasi teamwork is one of our core values. So now let's have our value-added rubrics. Okay, naatay rubrics for the group performance, naputay rubrics for the individual reporting. So kani siya nga page kaning nawong is isa lang ni siya ka copy per group ang iprint ani, no? Kasi this is where you're going to put all your tay group 1 ka, then dire naman ang topic ninyo. Sa topic ninyo tag good governance. Okay, group member, pila mo kabuk sa group? In order na siya kung kinsa ang first, second, third, fourth, fifth nga reporters. Okay, kaning individual reporting, it actually have 40 points diri a. It's because, di ba, when you're going to do your report, I will evaluate you based on the other na rubrics na to. So, diri a, maningkamot ta kasi it has the highest points, no? Among all the other criteria. So, 40 points na siya, imuha na siyang individual nga pagpaningkamo during sa imuhang reporting. And then, for the output naman, is that everybody is required to present by a PowerPoint presentation or other na tools like Canva or Prezi, depende sa inyo ha. Basta na amoy ma-present sa klase. And guys, per group, you are going to provide your own laptop and I will give you the connectors, no, para ma-project sa kuan, sa projector nato. So, 20 points ang output nato, pero na ako i-take note diri. Output. 2 points deduction per student who is absent or doesn't prepare any PowerPoint presentation during their scheduled report. Okay, 20 points will be the highest score. Okay, now, ang scheme manggod sa uban during sa reporting, manggawas ang tanang sakit. Magpa-absent-absent dayon, pera lang sa tinuod. Okay, so, if you are going to do that without any giving us excuses, for example, damay ang inyuhang mga classmate. Okay, pareha tanan o kanang ratings ang diria. Kaning diria. Kaning tulo ka criteria kung i-combine na siya, teamwork na siya nga, ano, criteria. Whatever is the grade of the one is damay na jud na siya tanan. So, kung ikaw ni absent ka during sa time nga nag-report ka, okay, wala man lang pasabi, wala'y nag-take over, so automatic na atay minus 2 sa output na to. So, mahimo lang siya 18. Dili lang kay ikaw ang madedakan, ana, pero pati ang imuhang mga classmates is madedakan. Okay, we also have this question and answer, no, portion. So, for the question and answer, everybody is required nga, ano, everybody should answer the question kanang magtinabangay kay whatever is the answer of one, apektado biya jud mo tanan, no? So, what if nagpataka lang siya answer? What if dili sufficient iyang answer? What if kulang ang iyang answer? Okay, so, whatever is the performance of the one answering that question, damay ang tanan. Okay lang unta tug maayo kayo pagkatubag sa inyong classmate. So, meaning, if you will have a certain ano na topic per group, dili lang kay ang imuha lang imong studyhan, pati ang mga topic sa imuhang mga kauban dapat studyhan pud na nimo, because how can you give your own insights for the specific na mga questions if ever na wala kay idea sa ilahang topic. Okay, so that's why everybody is required to study sa tanan ng mga topic na. So questions can be coming from your classmates and also from me, no? So other groups rating, okay, of course dili lang kay sa ako amo magpa-impress, but also you have to let your audience be captivated with your report, no? So ang per group pod nga sa per group pod, other groups pod is naa silay part nga mo rate pod sila based sa inyong performance, on what they perceived on your performance. 10 is the highest points also. So depende jud na sa ilaha na magbuhat sila own rubrics nila, for example. So depende na sa ilaha, ha. So whatever is the, I will get the average of the rating sa tay group 1 mag-report. So si group 2 hantod sa last nga group, they will be giving points, maximum is 10. So I will be giving the mean or the average of that para ibutang nako diri. But whatever is the rating sa kinatibukan, so of course, damay jud mong tanan. So mo na siyang dili jud pwede nga mag-iiyahay ta when it comes to our reporting. Okay? So kung i-add na siya tanan, total points is 100. Okay, question and answer. Every member of the group has a chance to answer the question given by their classmate or professor. The rate depends on how accurate and or how the reporter justifies his or her answer. 30 points will be the highest score. And also, no, when you answer the question, you also have to be confident with your answer. Kasi pag you will answer the question with also a question, it can give you an implication ba nga sure ka sa imong answer, mura magdili maka sure, no, mura mag-question pud nimo imong answer. So be mindful with that. Okay, for the other group's rating naman, after all the members of the group had reported, other group will rate them based on their overall performance during the report. They are given the freedom to make their own criteria, and the average result of other group's rating will be their score, and 10 points will be the highest. And pahimangno lang po di ay guys, during sa question and answer, ay during sa reporting, do not interrupt your classmates when it comes to during the reporting, I mean. So dili na to sila i-interrupt. Kay namagoy uban nga ma-question lang og simple or ma-interrupt lang sila during sa ilahang report, ma-mental block na dayon sila. So give each others a chance, no, nga maka-explain og tuloy-tuloy sa ilahang topic. Then I will just give you the kanang time later on in the question and answer to throw it, no? So i-take note lang ninyo unsa ang mga questions nga wala ninyo na, unsa ang mga items nga wala ninyo nasabtan sa ilahang gi-discuss. Okay, dili kay i-interrupt na to ang reporters in the middle of their report. Okay, that's for the kinatibuk-an na siya, ha. Again, kanin siyang page is that isa lang ni siya kakopy sa isa ka group. Okay? Then ang kaning individual, mo ni siya ang kaning isa-isa jud mo matag member na ay copy ani. Okay, so unsa man ang criteria nato for your reporting? First is content. Naabay unod ang imuhang gina-discuss? Naaba siya practical examples? Brief and concise ba siya pagka-discuss? As much as possible, you have to be direct to the point. Ayaw nang murag magtuyok-tuyok ganita sa isa ka-discussion, giving too much emphasis nga sabta naman siya unta. So, murag ka nang i-trim down po siguro ang inyong discussion, no, nga kuan kay magka-short ta sa oras ana if ever nga dili na ninyo ma-trim down inyong topic. So, at most is the 10 minutes ang allotted time per reporter. So, you have to trim it down to 10 minutes. Clarity, no? Ang clarity includes ka nang speaks clearly and distinctly all the time. Wala ba ka nag-mumble? wala ba ka kanang nga-nga. So, part po na, maka-apekto yun po ang confidence ni mo in front, no? And also, does not mispronounce words. So, part na siya sa clarity. And part sa clarity po di ay, guys, no, ang voice na to, nadunggan ba sa pinakalikod ang imuhang gina-istorya or basig ikaw rin nakadungog sa imuhang report? Okay, so part po na siya, na. Then, we also have this delivery. So, stands up straight, look relaxed and confident, establishes eye contact with everyone in the room during the presentation. So, if ikaw magsigla kag tan-aw, magsigla kag basa sa imong notes, sigla kag tan-aw sa blackboard, sigla kag tan-aw sa ceiling, for example, wala ka naga establish og eye-to-eye contact and connection with your audience, so your delivery will be affected, no? And sa language naman, guys, 80-20 ang i-follow na itong rule, ha? 80% English, 20% vernacular. So, dili siya other way around. Okay, so, I believe that there are important terms, no? Mas fit siya i-discuss using our native language or vernacular language. That's why, ato asyang gina combine, no? So, mauna siya, guys, those are the things nga dapat nato bantayan in order for you to get the 40 points na perfect score. And I will be giving comments and suggestions po during your report. Okay, so, kaning value-added rubrics, I already sent this sa Quipper. You have to download it and then you have to produce it. Dapat, before ang start sa inyong report is that naka-produce na ni siya, naka-photocopy na ni siya. Dili kay maupaganay pag during sa report manggawas kay mag-photocopy. Nahatag naman in advance sa inyo, ha? So you have to photocopy that in advance, okay? Okay, let's go back. Okay, few reminders na lang, no? Regularly check your Quipper for updates. Dili na ko magsige og remind sa inyo, ha, sa GC nga, oy, nakigisend sa Quipper, ano. It's your responsibility to check your Quipper every day. And then, refrain from chatting unnecessary information in our GC. I-maintain na to, guys, nga, ang GC na to, purely for announcement lang and kanang subject-related na mga information. Okay? Kaya ang uban, kay naay mag-send dirag magpa-like sa picture. Okay, ayun na lang ina. Na dito na nasa uban ng mga GC. No, natay mga important na mga announcement, mga tabunan because of that. If you have kana murag mag-convo na no unsa sa GC, nga pwede ra man unta i-PM inyong classmate kasi it does not concern the others. So do that na lang, dili kay sa GC mo magsigi og storya. Okay, so, and if you have personal concerns like health concerns, that would be the time nga mag-send mo private message ako. So, it happened before ba nga, na ano siya, kanang, na ay nahitabo sa iya, ha, na ay accident. Karon ang mga pictures is that ipang send niya sa GC niya, na yung mga maselan, sensitive nga mga kuan ba ng mga parts sa pictures nga dili siya dapat makita sa inyong mga classmates. So, of course, you have to think kung appropriate ba ni siya i-send sa GC or i-PM na lang nako si ma'am, no? So, if it concerns everyone, that would be the time na mo-chat sa GC. But if it only concerns you yourself, that would be the time na mag-private message mo sa kuha. And then, always keep your blue book. Future concerns with your grade will not be entertained if you'll not bring your blue book. So, after sa examination, maghahatag jud kog time ana for the checking. And then, i-distribute na nako balik sa inyo, ha, for your awareness. Now, kung mureklamo mo in the future sa inyong grade, nga nung 3 lang or 3.5 lang, dapat 4 siya, wala na siya problema. Dalaan lang jud ang inyuhang kanang blue book. Kay mauman na ako ang basihan pod kay, of course, no, human as we are, basi na ay mga cases nga namali na ko siya og record ana. So if ever that will happen, so of course you will get your tamang grade, no? So willing ka ayo ko mo correct ana, but of course kailangan sa jud pakita sa pod kog evidence nga namali ko. So ang evidence ana is yung blue book ninyo. So, be on time in class, dili kay 30 minutes na lang nabilin mo upay pagsulod niya, mura ra pa jud wala. Walay mga pa good morning, walay mga pa ano mura ra kuan ba? Kanang control kaayo ninyo ang time ninyo. Remember, 1 hour lang biya ang ato ang klase. And respect the time of others. Respect the time of your classmates. Kasi nagpasok sila on time, tapos ikaw late kaayo ka, no? So you have to be sensitive regarding that. And maintain proper decorum at all times. Okay, naay time, naamoy private time to browse your Facebook, to have a chat with your classmates. So during our class time, lend your ears fully on our sa ato ang klase. Okay, do not make unnecessary na mga actions or behaviors na diraa sa inyuhang lingkuranan. And of course, muna siya akong mabantayan no, nga wala jud gina-follow sa most of you. So wear your complete uniforms. No, non-wearing of uniform will be referred to OSA for disciplinary action. Now, naapoy case nga pwede ka ma-exempt on wearing the uniform, most especially if you are a working student. So naay permit ana nga ihatag si OSA sa inyo ha. Okay? So please follow directives kay para smooth ang dagan sa ato ang klase, guys. Okay, reminder po di ay, our class reporting will start on Monday. And then, since kanang nagka-problema man ta karon sa, unsa no, namay kanang weather interruption. So, dili na tumakuha ang books dito sa library. I will give you a scanned copy na lang of our books. Of our book for lesson 1 and lesson 2. Kay maumagwid ang affected sa ano sa next week kay ang first na tong reporters are group 1 and group 2. Okay, so if you have any question, do not hesitate to chat on our GC and I will entertain questions in our GC, guys, by the way. And of course, thank you so much for listening and for understanding no nga wala ta naka-meet in the past week and also this time, wala ta nakamit atong Monday gani. Supposed to be mo, sulod ko, but then we have an emergency meeting. Okay, so thank you for understanding and then also keep safe also at all times, no? Kay labi na karon nga naapay baha. So that's it and good day everyone.